Okay, this is a little bit embarrassing. I came out to the garden to do the video today, and I felt really good, and the morning dew's out, and I'm walking out to the garden, and I came out here, and I sat down right here, and I got myself all positioned, and I realized I don't have a camera. So I had to go all the way back into the house and get the camera. I didn't have a camera out here. I don't know what the hell I was thinking. I was sitting here looking at this direction, and I thought, there's no camera there. What the hell is going on? So, yeah, you can just imagine where my mind is today. I don't know. So, yeah, here I am. Got my camera. Of course I got my camera. You can see me. I got my camera. Okay, all right. Enough of that silliness. Actually, there's never enough silliness. I have a video to do today about something really strange. I wanted to show you guys my garlic. What I did was I came out, planted the elephant garlic, you know, I put the cloves in the ground and covered it up. It's not rocket science. Anybody can do it. And so I planted this like a while back in May. And it didn't come up. It didn't come up. And everything else is growing. And I have a lovely garden. And I thought, what the hell's going wrong? I mean, did I buy bad garlic or what? And so the other day I was weeding the garden. And I thought, oh, what the hell? I'm going to dig this up and plant more radishes or something. I have a garden failure, you know, no garlic this year. So I was pulling out all the weeds, and then I went to go dig up where the bulbs were because I didn't want rotten bulbs in the ground. And check out what I found. I'll take you over there. Check it out. So I come over to the elephant garlic bed, and it's kind of overgrown with weeds because I planted elephant garlic, and it was a total failure. So I just kind of ignored it and let it go to weeds. I know I should have kept it weeded, but I figured, why? The elephant garlic's not coming up. And I just figured, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. And I decided, well, I'm going to use this bed this year because I have too much lettuce in the other bed, so I'm going to clear out the weeds, hoe this up, and transplant the lettuce, and check out what I found. So I pulled the dirt aside here. I already did this before, so the dirt's already loosened, and look what I found. This is an entire, elephant garlic plant. It's got the little cloves and everything on it. It grew totally underground with no leaves. You know how garlic and onions always send out these leaves? This sent out no leaves. It was just a little tiny green tip showing above the dirt. And I thought all this time it was just that little clove of garlic. It actually grew all these other cloves and formed a garlic plant. So I'm going to just leave it underground and see how big it gets. I just wanted to show you guys this because I thought this was like the most amazing thing. I've never, ever heard of this happening. Plants growing with no leaves. Just totally underground. Isn't that strange? Yeah, the other ones are doing the same thing too. I dug up them and found that they were doing the same thing underground, so I got all these big ass garlic plants growing underground. So I guess I gotta find some other place to put my lettuce. I don't know how it does that. I could see one of them doing it, like maybe some kind of freak of nature or something like that, but all of them? That was the weirdest thing. So strange, huh? I know it's weird. I don't know. Maybe it's happened to you guys before, but this has never happened to me. I've never had garlic just growing underground and, you know, screw the sun. We don't need the sun. So, yeah, that was weird. Different. So anyway, if you guys have ever had that happen to you or anything really stupid, let me know, all right? It'd be nice to know I'm not the only one that has a haunted garlic patch. A couple people asked about saving seeds from potatoes, and one person, Augustus Larch, who's a friend of mine on YouTube, he has his own channel, he suggested that I save the seeds and grow potatoes from seeds for next year. I've never done that, and I never really thought about it because, you know, I've always grown them from, like, parts of potatoes. And I thought, you know what, why didn't I even think of that? Because I'm always trying to find something different to do in my garden and not do it like everybody else and try something else. So I'm going to actually save seeds from these for next year and plant them from seed. Now, if you're growing potatoes, there's no need to worry if yours are going to go to seed. They will go to seed. Just let them grow long enough, and more than likely, they're going to put out flowers. So, yeah, I'm going to save seeds from this. I'll put that on my seed video when, you know, towards the end of the season. But anyway, yeah, I just wanted to show you guys the update. It's doing really good. And, you know, I thought I was going to really, you know, pull a fast one this year on Mother Nature and grow my spinach inside my asparagus patch because I thought, you know, the asparagus is going to get really tall. It's going to shade the spinach. That was a great idea, but this year, for some reason, it was just extra hot. I mean, we had a lot of rain. It was extra hot, and the spinach just grew really fantastic. So I got spinach really early, which was nice. Only problem is heat causes spinach to bolt. And what I mean by bolt is it sends up a flower. And so yeah, I got like spinach pollen all over the place, which is okay. And the spinach leaves aren't quite as nice when it bolts. They start to get a little bit bitter. Yeah, it's bitter. Okay. What I was going to tell you, I forgot. I'm letting it stay bolted like this. Instead of normally I pull it out and take all the leaves and throw it in the compost pile. This year I'm going to let it go to seed because I'm going to do a video on how to save seeds from just about everything in my garden. I get requests like, how do you save seeds on this, this, this? This year I'm going to try and save seeds from everything. So I'm going to do some footage, save it till I get, you know, I always do this, but till I get enough footage. All right? Spinach, going to seed. You know, one thing that does really well is bush beans. I never have a problem with bush beans. Pole beans, sometimes they're a little bit slow growing up the thing, but bush beans always come out really nice. Last year I grew them in between the corn, remember that? And it sucked trying to get at them because I have to reach between the corn to get in there, and I was pushing the corn all over and I didn't like that. This year I decided to grow them where I grew peppers last year, and this is an 8-foot long bed by only about a foot wide. So it's really cool. I mean, I can get to them from either side and they get full sun. So that's actually really nice. And even though beans don't need nitrogen that much because they have the symbiotic thing going on with bacteria or some kind of weird fungus in the ground, I don't know what it is, but something's going on down there. They have some kind of bacteria that lives down in the ground or fungus that makes nitrogen for them, and in turn their roots support that bacteria, so it's like, you know, works back and forth. They do appreciate nitrogen. They like it. I mean, these things are doing wonderful. So they're starting to flower. I'm going to have beans in like no time. And then I'm going to have too many beans about a week after that. All right, time to go do something else. Bye.